to take a little time, little time to think things over. Better read between the lines in case I need it when I'm older. Mountain I must climb feels like a world upon my shoulders. Through the clouds I see love shine, keeps me warm as life grows colder.
Recording. I was gonna say, are you channeling her voice?
I think so.
So, anyways, how are you doing? We haven't talked as much this week as we do sometimes. It's been too crazy.
No, yeah, it's been a little crazy. What was that?
I don't know why. What? Hey.
I don't know what that noise was on my computer. It was very strange.
Everything is strange these days. I begin to wonder if I'm in, like, the twilight zone.
All right. I'm sorry. Un poco ya maya oda e piano unia crescete si chiane ane maya chieta. Un po' triane muya e cosciuto ya ne chiata. Namaste.
Namaste.
Okay. When it comes, it comes.
I know. I know, I'm used to it. Thank goodness.
Good evening, Deborah.
Ah, Kuthumi, you are here already. You said you were making your debut. I said you could just speak for me instead. How about you and Keleena have a show together? How's that?
Keleena, should we hang her up? No, Debbie's gone.
Debbie's gone. Yeah, just mute me. I'm a host there, Kuthumi. Can't do
it
that
to me.
It's
the Kuthumi show. Kuthumi Keleena.
Oh.
Yeah, KK. Oh, yes.
Stop it. Listen, I've got to tell a quick Kuthumi story. I'm driving home in this pouring rainstorm, and Keleena and I are on the phone, and Katumi's talking to me. And I was like pulling over and going, oh my God, it's so bad and all this stuff. And then finally I decided to brave it back out into the storm. And I hear, well, we're in the car with you, you know. I'm like, you are. And then all of a sudden it cleared up. And there was, like, no rain. Yeah. And I'm like, what did you put, like, the big cosmic umbrella over my car? I said, why did you come into the car, like, an hour ago when I was, like, scared to death to be driving? Oh, my God. But I'm
serious. You didn't ask us.
I told you.
So now you know. If you're in a situation, call me, and I'll bring the masters in.
Yay! Well, I'm sure if I had just called and said, Kuthumi, come right in my car. I just didn't know that we'd have a cosmic umbrella over us and that the rain would stop.
You need more walnuts. I'm sure on the previous shows, I have told you that we're always here for you.
I know it. I hear you.
I don't think he said when you're driving, though.
Yeah, well, I just didn't think of it. I was on with Keleena. I was talking
does
to her.
Matter?
Keep me calm.
When you're on with Keleena, you are on with all.
That is very true.
It's going to be one of those nights.
Yes, it is. Good.
Oh, God.
Anyway.
Let's raise the vibrations, because too many of you out there have been having issues with this Venus retrograde and the spring equinox energies and all of the other things are going on. And there's another retrograde going on. And you all are focusing on the wrong things. You need to be focusing on joy and love.
Well,
and that's the end of the show
for me today. Sorry. I mean, you know. All right, guys. Welcome to Friday night with Debbie and Keleena and Kuthumi, okay? Because this is what it's like. Seriously, this is real
life
now, okay? This is real life.
Oh, wouldn't it be funny, a reality TV show?
Oh, my gosh.
People would think I'm not. Well, maybe they are.
Well, you know what? It's,
oh, well.
It's all right. I know you're not. No. We're all
right. Right.
No, but Kuthumi, you're so right. Really. I mean, if I had been able to focus on joy, but it was like,
mm-hmm. Keleena, did you do a video yesterday where you said something about the people always being in the too much noise? I did.
Mm. Yeah, that was one of those days.
It was one, but I don't remember if that was Goddess I was channeling, or if that was Chamuel. I can't remember. Archangel Chamuel maybe said that. So I don't take the credit for that. But why not? He brought it through. Because it wasn't my message. Oh, my God, I'm having a conversation with him and myself here. Ugh.
I know. It's okay. It's okay. I'm used to it.
Okay, sorry.
Okay.
That was some kind of activation, so whoever's listening.
Okay. Please activate me.
He just pushed a button.
He did?
It's for a joke. He, you know, he puts that in my third eye. Like, he's pushing a button when I went. All right.
Okay. So what are we going to talk about tonight?
Well, what was the subject of the show? Past lives and clearing or something like that?
Yeah.
You picked it out early in the week.
Yeah.
That's so funny. What are we talking about tonight?
Well,
dear Deborah.
Yes.
Why don't we work on you?
I knew you'd say that. Yeah, you know, I got to be honest with everybody. This has been the most challenging couple of days for me. I will just come out and say it. My mother had surgery on Wednesday, and I spent time in the hospital with her and my sister and, you know, just spent a lot of time. Whew. It was very tiring, and I've got that going on with my work thing going on, with the person, all the personal stuff that's going on, and I'm getting ready to move, so I've got to move my house, and I've got, you know, kids coming and going. So it has been very challenging, and I have been probably, like most people, revisiting a lot of situations, not just a little, a lot. Like every other minute, something new comes up for review, and I was doing really, really good there in the very beginning. Halfway through Venus retro, I started having some challenges. I think today I hit a wall. And I just literally, I was working today with my partner, and he's usually really helpful, helping me clear stuff. And it was kind of like, nope, that was revisiting stuff. So I was revisiting stuff with the work situation. I was revisiting stuff with relationship situations. I mean, in other words, everywhere I turned, this continual revisiting. And I know the rules of thumb. You go outside, you ground yourself. I don't know how many times I grounded myself today, put my feet in the dirt. You know, I did talk with Keleena We did some work together. I did some work on my own. This was one of those days. It was very challenging. And so imagine, too, as I'm saying, oh, and I've got a show to do tonight. And, you know, and then it's like I'm used to being in my center and used to being, you know, like really able to access my own knowledge and my own information. And I'm sitting here going, okay, here I am, you know. So maybe it is really a good idea, you know, to talk about this, because certainly I cannot be the only person going through this. I mean, if I am, okay, I'm done. Someone just pick me up with the spaceship and take me out of here, because if I'm the only one, then I'm okay.
I shall take you in a beam of light. How's that?
That sounds good. Now? Now?
No, not all until right. You're done with all of the work you have to do on Earth first.
Thanks. I appreciate it. How much longer is that now? No answer.
I think you have about 40 years left.
No. Oh, my Lord. You mean I'm only going to live to be 90? Wait a minute.
Now you complain.
I'm complaining. I know, you know. I might as well be a Libra.
All right. God. Wait, what does that mean?
Oh, Libras change their mind all the time.
Oh.
And they argue both sides of the fence. And they, you know, they'll hop back and forth. I've got a ton of Libra friends. So, anyways, that's what that meant. Okay.
All right. Well, you're not the only one going through this. Was I think I said in my video yesterday that there's a ton of people that are messaging and just saying that they're having a hard time with Venus retrograde and everything else that's going on. And the activations that are coming in, too. I know I talked about that a few times. The light codes that are coming in through the sun, through the great central sun, through the sun, they're going into the grid points, and then they run through the ley lines, and they come up into us. And we are being activated so that we can keep our vibrations up, because Mother Earth's already been raised, so ours has to be at the same level, otherwise we cannot handle it here. And then for some people, it's just a lot, all of these things going on at once, and it's just like it's almost like a jumble in the body, and you're just like, you know, you're constantly getting jumbled and moved around. And if you don't know how to properly handle it, then people will start to feel anxious and like too much is going on and can't. Hold on 1 second. Overtired. Yes, thank you. They said overtired. So some people will feel overtired, but you have to listen to your body. So if your body says you're exhausted, then lay down. You know, if you're anxious about something, then do what you can to get that anxiety out of you. You just have to listen to your body and accept what's going on, acknowledge it, and take those little measures and those steps to relieve that the way that you know how. So I'm sorry, I've got some. I'm like way up. I'm floating now.
Good.
Way up.
And
I'm like
drafting,
way up.
Pull me up. But that's it. That's exactly what I was dealing with. I was dealing with my own anxiety, and I don't, you know, I've gotten to a place where I don't really get anxious about stuff, but I have been experiencing anxiety. You know, I've been experiencing that overwhelming sense of, oh, my God, how am I going to do all this? And I've got so many things going on in my life that are flowing and going in the right direction. And yet it's like I'm being overwhelmed by everything that I have to do and everything that, and I'm just like, whoa. Oh.
Yeah. It's okay. But you know what? The thing is that you, today, I was so proud of you when you caught what was going on. You acknowledged it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Because there was a year ago when you would have been like, ah!
Right.
I don't know what's going on. So, you know, you've acknowledged and you accepted it and knew that you had to do something to rid it. But there was more than one thing going on at the same time for you. So,
yeah.
It's just like bam,
multiple
bam, bam.
Levels. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And it can go deep and deeper and deeper and deeper. And hold on 1 second. I have a huge angel here. I just want to see what. Oh, Chami was here again. I have been working. He's been here like the last 4 days for me.
Wow.
Oh, Tibia. Okay. He's just going to stop. He's staying in the sacred space for now for the show.
Okay, super.
Oh, gosh. Good. Kuthumi. He is interacting with him, so and I could see everything,
right,
in my third eye what he's doing, and he's such a goofball. I mean, it's funny because people don't know the ascended masters. There are other people that channel Kuthumi, and then there's people that say they can channel to me. But remember, there's if you're not calling in the benevolent person, there's that other energy out there that claims they're Kuthumi that is really not Kuthumi. If you're not calling in the benevolent ascended masters, you're bringing in the wrong energies. I've gone and I wanted to see what some of these other people were bringing through with Kuthumi, and I went and listened, and I was like, uh-oh. And so I invited Kuthumi in to listen to it, too, and he started laughing, and he said, that's not me. I was like, oh, God. Mm-hmm. So you have to be very careful. I just want to remind people again, because, and I remind all the clients, if you're going to call in energies, if you're going to call in angels, you're going to call in your guides, make sure you use the word benevolent beforehand. Otherwise, you can call in any energy that's hanging out there that you really don't want to have in your life, because some of them can attach to you and stuff like that, and you don't need that. So make sure you please use that word. That's very, very important. And with you yesterday, Deb, the energies that you picked up being in that hospital, now that... You know, that happens.
Right.
And sometimes you just don't know it because there are certain places, big places, where you can pick up energies that, especially if people passed away in an area, but they decided not to cross over,
mm-hmm.
and they see your light, and they mm-hmm. feel like, okay, you can help them, they will attach to you. They attach the aura. Mm-hmm. So that can happen, too. You just have to...
Right.
Empathic abilities and stuff, if you have them and you're knowing. I have got a bunch of people coming in, so I'm just going to allow everybody that's coming in. I've got a bunch of masters coming in. And I wanted to let everybody know that the masters truly are fun. They are about love and joy. And everybody always thinks that they're going to be stern and, you know, all about the sacred geometry and the mathematical equations whatever is written in the books or whatever people write, you know, saying that they're very, like we are focused in direction. I'm going to let you take over. Well, we are focused in direction, but we do have a sense of humor because in truth and in reality, your experience on the earth is to be in love. And with love comes joy. Mm-hmm. You came for the experience of love in many different ways. That's why it's here.
Yeah.
And love is meant to be simple. And it's simple when you're in your heart, not when you're in your head. Think about it. If you're stuck up in that ego all day long, at your workplace, and you're not from your heart in your workplace because you don't like the person in the cubicle next to you or the office behind you, of the person that's shelving a book over here, you're constantly in your thoughts of negativity, aren't you? Instead of staying in your heart and thinking,
right,
I love my job. I am grateful that I have my job. I am grateful I have a paycheck. I am grateful for this space they have given me to do my work. Instead, we're like, oh, I don't like what Sally's wearing today. And, oh, there's Jim, and he smells. You know what I'm seeing? And there's Bob over here. He did not refill the coffee pot. So, please, that is ridiculous. That's all the stuff that does not matter.
Mm-hmm.
We should be in our heart, and we should be happy, and we should exude the love that we are no matter where we are. Because when you do that, you get it back. When you give the love, you give joy. And let me tell you, if all of you that are listening, go out and do that next week when you go back to work. And for those of you that must work on the weekend, if you do that, You're the one that's going in to make the change. You go to work in the morning, and you be the love that you are. And you be happy, and you have that smile on your face. And you tell Sally, oh, that's a beautiful blouse, even if you don't like it. You understand? It changes all of the energy around you. It makes people happy. It raises the vibrations in the workspace. And you do it in your home. And you do it in your school. You do it wherever you are. You do it in a restaurant. Don't be rude to the waiters and waitresses that bring you water. Maybe it has a spicy cup. You know what I'm saying by spicy cup. It might have a little dirt on it. It's not their fault. Just say, may I have another glass of tea? Thank you so much. Instead of saying, let's have something in the water. Because I have seen some of you do it, and I watch you. And you don't like your lemon in your water because it's a mushy pea. I've seen some of you complain the silly things that you say. Instead of being grateful, you are the opposite. How do we change the world when we can't be positive ourselves? Good question, isn't it? Think about it in your daily life when you get up in the morning. When you're sending your children off to school, send them off with a smile. And when you send your children off with a smile, they go to school with a smile. And it keeps going, it domino effect. When you go to work in the morning, try this.
Uh-huh.
And if somebody is still negative, allow them their space, because you don't know what's going on in their life. But always let them come to you if they need to and be that ear for them. You are the better person when you can listen sometimes. And you just send back the love from your heart. It's that simple. Life is meant to be simple.
Mm-hmm.
Life is meant to be love. And life is meant to be joy. And that's how we raise the vibrations on this planet. And that's how you raise the vibrations within yourself. Not a hard thing to do, is it? Yes, Deborah.
Well, you know, most of the days I feel I live like that, you know. I feel like I live like that a lot. And
you do
yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's you know, it's just those days, you know, and how to just forgive myself for having those days where I'm just not in joy, you know, for whatever reason. How do you, you know, move past that?
Have we talked about when you go back and do the things that you absolutely love? When you think of the things that you love, when you think of the things that raise your vibration?
Yeah.
Put on some great music.
Yeah. I didn't do any of those things.
Get out in nature.
But I mean, literally.
This is something that, even though we repeat it and repeat it, it always has to be a reminder. But why?
Well, especially when you're super busy like I've been, it's like, yeah, I don't have time to go right now to my horses. I don't have time to play my guitar right now. I mean, I can't even breathe or go to the bathroom. I mean, it's that busy. And, you know, when you're in that space,
okay, I'm
how do you remind yourself?
Stop.
Okay.
I think there's been times when Kalina has told you to write it on a post-it note. Yes, because I've been
mm-hmm.
there. So you can stop and take a break. Anybody can say, I need 10 minutes for my sanity. Correct?
Yeah, I'm a driver. I drive myself, so I'm not really thinking
about
it.
Well, then stop driving and turn off the car.
Yeah.
Turn it off. Walk outside and get those feet in nature. Touch a tree.
Well, I definitely go outside as much as I can. I walk out all the time.
I know.
Sometimes,
I saw you this
sometimes
morning.
Sometimes not to the pleasure of people I'm working with. I got to go outside. Again? Yes. Yeah.
But you're getting, do you see, the more you do it, it becomes a habit.
Right. And I've done so well. It's just the last couple of days, it's just been a crescendo. And I ought to just be a little bit easier on myself instead of harder on myself. I've got my post-it notepad out, okay? I'm writing a big, huge thing.
All right.
To put on my computer.
Because if you don't write it now, I'm going to have to double your dose of walnuts.
I wrote take 10, okay? I'm putting up a post-it that says take 10.
Oh, I like it.
You like it?
Yeah.
Is that a good coping mechanism? Take 10.
Absolutely. Take 10. That could be take 10 of anything. Take 10 minutes.
I know.
Take 10 jelly beans. Take 10 moments.
Take these 10 deep breaths.
You could be. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Perfect. I like it. Yeah. Good idea.
Mm-hmm. 10 minutes of listening to your favorite music. 10 minutes of jumping.
Okay.
If you have a trampoline, I would love it.
10 minutes of Kuthumi.
10 minutes of Kuthumi. Yep.
Oh. All right. So, am I speaking today, or shall I step back so Keleena can speak?
That's up to Keleena. Right. It's up to you two.
Are we working on you for a little bit, Deborah? Shall we get
into
you?
Well, it depends. I don't know. Do I need work? What?
Well, you tell us. Do we need to go within?
Yeah, I need to go within.
All right. Tell me. Go on. Keleena, I will work on you. Let's go.
Oh, no. I thought I'd go in within myself.
No, we were going to help you release something, clear something.
Right.
Do you need help? It's all right. You can say if you need it. Somebody out there may benefit from it.
Yeah, but I'm in a conundrum. You've got to know what my conundrum is.
I know what your conundrum is. Conundrum, conundrum, whatever. Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
There's always a conundrum, isn't there?
Mm-hmm.
That's the noise that's up in the head. That's what a conundrum is.
Yeah.
Illusion.
Well, I guess that's the biggest...
And I know you beg to differ. Go on.
Well, no, I guess I'm dealing with some fundamental clearing issues. It's perfect for this show. I mean, you know, I have someone that's really important in my life that pretty much, you know, thinks that I need to be clearing my stuff on my own and letting go. And knowing full well that this mm-hmm. person could hear this radio show and pretty much say, oh, well, you're not able to clear this stuff on your own. And it's like, I'm having some issues with fundamental belief systems, you know, mm-hmm. struggling with belief systems and seeing both sides of the coin. You know?
All right. Well, first of all, let me say one thing.
Yeah.
Sometimes one needs assistance clearing things because they may be at a pivotal point where they are not in the right space where they can do it themselves.
Yeah.
And there is nothing wrong with asking for help. That's why we're all here, and that's why I say all the time, we're all here.
Right.
Ask us. We will assist you.
Well, this person's pretty important to me and has been very instrumental in a lot of the spiritual growth that I've had. And I'm sure doesn't realize it, but, you know, there's just a level of judgment.
Yes.
Like I should be above. Like I should be above that period. Where I need help from anybody else.
Well, let me ask you a question then.
Yeah.
You feel like that is being placed upon you. But I'm going to ask you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel that way about yourself? Are you judging yourself? Do you yourself feel like you should be beyond that?
Maybe.
All right. Because you feel that tension a little bit, I would say, from this person. So then you put the what we would call the emotion on yourself and the thought process on yourself that you are judging yourself, and now you've gone into the next thought, I should be doing this by myself, because I know in my head that he or she is probably thinking that I should be doing this on my own, but I just can't right now. I need your assistance. I need someone's assistance.
Yeah.
So we must remember, even though the words may not come out of the other person's mouth, and we are thinking this, it's only because sometimes we are placing it there ourselves.
Yeah. Well, isn't that true? Projection.
Exactly. And that is what you call the mirror effect.
Right. Yeah.
So when you
that's kind of what I've been dealing with on, you know, on the deeper levels, is that, you know, this person is really amazing. And so it's not a judgment of the other person as much as it's a reflection of where I am at my point right now.
Absolutely.
Which is, you know, I have had some incredible, incredible glimpses at mastery. Incredible glimpses at mastery. I mean, some of the stuff that I've been doing, just seeing the transformation of my entire life taking place before me, it's just, it's stellar. It's beautiful. It's incredible.
Of course.
But sometimes you're just not there. Yeah.
And what is not there?
Just sometimes you're just not there. Sometimes you're just not in the flow for whatever reason.
Because sometimes you have too many things and the noise going on.
Yeah.
So the flow isn't happening the way that you would like it to.
Well, and yes, and let me just, I'm letting myself out in front of people.
You're releasing, it is okay, they understand.
When you experience the flow and you know what that feels like to be in any other state is absolute agony for me.
Not
because it is
you.
So incredible to experience being in the flow. Yeah. Everything is supported by the universe. Everything you do moves in incredible symphony and orchestra. It is the most incredible, beautiful experience to live.
Yeah.
And then it goes away for a period of time. And for me, it is excruciating. It is so hard for me.
And may I say something here now?
Yeah.
Is that when sometimes the flow is interrupted, do you notice if you're in love and joy at that time? Or if you're in another space?
No, I'm always in a different state. I can do laughing here and there, but yeah.
All right. Because you see, if we aren't truly in that state of being, of love, you can be interrupted at any time. And that's why I began to show about the love and joy.
Right.
Now, does that make sense? So if
we're
not taking ourselves to that higher vibration, that fifth dimensional, well, I'm not going to call it the fifth dimensional. I will not, because nobody can get into, and I'm going to say this now, for those of you listening, those of you that will listen, the fifth dimension and higher, there is no karma allowed. There is no negativity. So if you think you've cleared yourself and you think you're somebody upon the earth that's walking around with no karma, no negativity, and you're this great exasperated white being of love, I would like to see you. Because right now, most people are in the fourth dimension. There are some people that are in the fifth dimension. Those are the ones that have to carry the higher vibrations to do some of the work that they are doing as way showers. And I want to let everyone know that. Because there's a lot of people out there that believe they are fifth dimensional, or they're in that state of fifth dimensional mindset. And maybe you think it for a moment, and you could be in it for a moment, but you cannot stay there if you have not cleared yourself. If you have not stepped into your wholeness, into the true spiritual being that you are. And I just want to say that, because there's there's a lot of people out there writing about, oh, we're all in the fifth dimension. No, not yet. It will be a while. There are only some people that have to remain there. They're very much in their light bodies for the work that they must do. And the rest of you will get there in time.
Mm-hmm.
So, Deborah, now I will continue.
Mm-hmm.
When you take yourself back to that higher state of being in love, and love and joy, that's when the flow continues.
Mm-hmm.
And when one is, when let's say when one has many things set upon them, as you have this week, and you almost feel like all of these, I'm going to say, weights are being placed upon the shoulders, you've got all this going on and this and this and this and that, and you start feeling weighed down, and it's squishing you down, like your little Michelin man, I think they call that little man, a squishy man, and mm-hmm. you look like a marshmallow, just squishing and squishing and squishing. And you're squishing smaller and smaller, and you're stretching out wider and wider, and you can't stretch any wider to help anyone else, can you?
No.
And you're starting to feel really thin.
Mm-hmm.
Flat. I will call it flat, because the marshmallow is not flattened.
Right.
Is it not?
Yes.
Yeah. You feel flat.
Yeah, that's how I felt this morning when I woke up. I felt flat.
All right. Well, there you go.
Right.
You feel flat. Like you can't do anything. You don't want to do anything. Like there's just blah. This is how Keleena calls it. It's been a while since you said blah, Keleena. Yeah, it's been a while. All right. So when we're flat, what do we have to do? We have to fill ourselves back up.
Right.
We have to start taking that stuff off of us that does not matter. The illusions of this world. Yes, this person had to have this done, and this person needs this thing by this time, and this person needs a lunch made. You know what? Sometimes these people can do things themselves. And this person wants this or that. You know what? Move it to another day. Because you know what? In the end run, it is all the illusion, and those things are still going to be there. They will still be there. The thing that is the most important is your soul's journey. It is you. You are the most important thing to yourself right now.
Right.
You can only extend yourself so much on what the energies of everything going on the retrograde. You're reviewing a lot of the things that you have gone through this week. Was a review. Was it not?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was review of many things in your life.
Right.
And it just weighed you down and weighed you down more and more. So
exactly.
Now you must look at them. Yes. Now you must look at them and say, is that something I'm going to participate in anymore in my life, in my relationships?
Right.
Is that something I want to change?
Right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
That is Venus retrograde. And it's not just love relationships. It's all relationships. It's family. It is children. It is husbands, it is ex-husbands, it is ex-wife, it's wife, it's girlfriends, it's everything. It is co-workers.
Mm-hmm.
It's everything. Even the relationship with your pets.
Yeah.
You're not going to be snipping at me anymore, mister, because I'm going to take you to someone who's going to fix that. They'll teach you not to nip. You see, it's all relationships. It's the relationship with the tree outside that you keep driving through the driveway and hitting its branch. Well, you know, don't cut it off. Go just tie it up a little bit, and that tree will be so happy.
Yeah.
You see? It's a relationship with everything, because everything is interweaved.
Yeah.
Everything. And when we make little adjustments, and we get ourselves back in love, we are back in joy, and everything flows.
Yeah.
It's that simple. You make
and that's
it
what I forgot.
So hard. Humans make it so hard.
Yep.
Stay out of the ego. Stay out of the noise. Seriously, I'm going to say something right now about your social media, and maybe some of you will not like it. But who really cares about who so-and-so said about someone? Seriously, who cares? Does it matter? Because then look what that does. It entangles you into a web. And the web weaves bigger and bigger, and you can't stay off of that social media because you're watching the web grow, and you want to be part of it. And then you get to the point where you get angry about what somebody else said, and where are you? You're in ego again, instead of living your life. for the reason mm-hmm. he came for. He didn't come for that, I will call it, crap. That's what a lot of it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's one thing to go on your social media to find things that are tools or learning devices. But it's another thing to go on there and complain about someone or put negative things on and lower people's vibrations. It's not worth it, is it, when it takes someone else down or it takes yourself down? There's no flow when you do that. Everything stops. And then the rest of the day, you're thinking about, oh, my God, so-and-so said this or did that. Doesn't matter, does it?
Mm-mm.
Keep yourself in the love and keep yourself in the joy and keep yourself in the flow. Why you're really here.
Right. Well, that, you know, if I had just, and again, it's all a learning process, but now I see actually where the existential problem started was, you know, my unawareness that it was, that I was becoming that flat marshmallow that you're talking about, that it was so slow. It was over a long period of time, and it was flattening me, flattening, flattening me. And I wasn't really recognizing it or even in my consciousness being able to see that I had gotten there, even myself. Maybe there was no dark energies as much as there was me feeling all the burdens that I had been feeling slowly, slowly, slowly pushing me down instead of focusing on raising my vibrations, which is what I would tell everybody else, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes we have the hardest time remembering for ourselves. Yeah. Because I'll tell you what, I could have started my day completely different because, you know, my work partner, nobody makes me laugh, you know, more than he does. Nobody. I mean, it could have just been a really lighthearted, fun day and laugh and laugh and laugh, but I was so down in, I, you know what I'm saying? I could have used other opportunities to bring myself up, and instead, I wasn't conscious, and that's interesting because, you know, even as conscious as I feel I am, I did not know that I had allowed my vibrations to fall like that. Interesting.
Right. So, and when you take care of yourself, and when mm-hmm. everyone takes care of themselves, and when everybody stays in the higher vibration, you change the Earth's consciousness as well. That's why you're here. Cleaning mm-hmm. up Gaia, assisting her, and humanity. We're assisting to teach humanity. So I am thankful that we had this conversation. I am grateful for your tears today because it helps you release, but I'm also grateful that I feel somebody will listen to this and learn from it.
Right.
So, end of the show. Let's go. Who wants to
okay,
make a
let's go.
Teacher Kuthumi.
I thought you want a banana cake. Now you want chocolate.
Today I feel like a chocolate.
One of these days I'm just going to sit down and bake all day, and I'm just going to say, Kuthumi, I'm baking for you today. And then, of course, I'm going to have to find someone to give all the cakes to because I do not need them.
Oh, because see, and after all, we just went through right now, now you owe me 1,001. So you have a lot of baking to do.
I have a lot of baking to do. I need to open up a bake shop. All right. Oh, well, Debbie had her therapy session in front of how many other people listen. That's nice.
Well, you're welcome.
Well, thank you. But you know what? This is, you know, I was absolutely needing that. And I hope that everybody out there that listens to this understands everybody's going to go through periods of time. It doesn't matter where you're at on your path. You know, feel okay with it. Be okay with it. I'm
okay with it. All right.
All
good.
Right.
Keleena, this is Keleena's work. We work through her. She is the conduit. You can call her Miss Conduit. Miss
Conduit
2017. Oh, my God.
Miss Conduit. Oh, like Miss America? You're Miss
yes.
Conduit.
Great. Lucky me. Lucky
oh,
me.
My gosh. Where are you here? Oh, okay. You got it back in. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so now are we going to take calls?
Well, go on, open up. Who wants to talk to Kuthumi?
Oh my God! I am be on the lookout. All right, who?
Guess
who's
I'm not getting
be
in
our first call in?
I will answer the call. Let's go. Who wants to talk to Kuthumi? Don't everybody rush now.
We can't do anything. You know what? We have to put it in question and answer mode. I can just hear my friend Cindy. My friend Cindy's on here. She's probably going, you need to put it in Q&A mode. See, she was an admin, a moderator or whatever for calls that I've been on in the past. Cindy, I really need you, dear. All right, I'm going to go ahead and put it in question and answer mode.
But she is going to France.
To what? Yes, yes. Do you remember Cindy that's going to France?
Yes, I know. I go see her sometimes. I know who she is.
Oh, you do? You crack me up sometimes. All right, I'm going to put it in Q&A.
Sure.
All right, Q&A session has started, and I don't know if it tells you, but if you would like to get into the queue to ask Kuthumi a question, forget off. No. Cindy, the first person. Cindy's in the queue. All right, Cindy, I'm going to go ahead.
She loves me.
I'm going to pick Cindy. Oh, and we've got a couple people lining up in the queue. People want to talk to Kuthumi. Yay. All right, Cindy.
Oh, it's
Cindy first.
Yes,
she got there first.
Hello, Cindy.
Second.
Wait, I will let Keleena say hello first, and then I will step in so she can. Yes, Keleena, step back. No, wait.
Okay.
Hang on.
Cindy,
hang on,
area code 503. Yes.
Hi, Cindy.
Kuthumi's...
Yes. And
hi.
And you said my name, and I kept saying, unmute me, damn it. Unmute. And every time I kept saying, it's muted, you can't talk.
Oh. Hugs. I'm giving you big hugs.
Okay. Oh, I'm just
hello, Miss Cindy. Have you gotten rid of those cats yet?
No.
Oh, my goodness. It's always going to be your excuse, isn't it? Remember,
no,
wow.
No, I love my cats. They're just, I haven't, the home I want to give them to is waiting, but I'm waiting for some money. But one thing I wanted to say to Debbie is what I heard the other day, and like everybody else, life is really interesting right now. Mm-hmm. So I go in, all of a sudden I go, this is effed. And then I go, be in the moment. And whether I'm driving or I'm standing, I just look around and I go, I look at things and just focus on that moment. And then, you know, keep shifting moment by moment. And that helps let go of all the conversation and the crap going in my head.
Yeah.
So try it on.
Yeah, I know. And it's like focusing on what's in front of you right now. And I live like that. Yeah, I live like that. Mm-hmm. That's the moment that I talk about where you're so much in the flow that the things that are happening in my life right now are miraculous. I mean, you couldn't get any more miraculous with the connections and the jobs that are coming to me and the move that's happening to me and my friendships, you know, blah, blah, blah. Boy,
and you
I
want
just,
me there to pack you up, right?
Yeah.
Wish I was.
Thanks, Cindy. Appreciate it.
So, Kuthumi, thank you. I think you are just hilarious. I laugh a lot when
I know
I get on this call. And today I was blessed to have this day off. And I was 30 miles away, and I had my cell phone set on alarm, and I went, oh, shit, am I going to make it home in time? Hey, I didn't say the other word.
Well, I would excuse you for the night. I would just tell people you were drinking.
Oh, no, I don't drink. If I'm going to do anything, it's smoke, and I don't do that anymore. So.
That's right, but I would still tell them that just to create a story like you people do on Earth.
Yes.
Don't you see what I am doing? You see?
Yes.
All right.
So I have this fabulous man in my life. His name is Francois.
Yes. He likes French.
Yes. He's French.
Well,
so yeah. Is there anything you would like to tell me about our relationship? Other
no.
than I...
okay. Next. I wish you guys could see what he puts in my third eye when he does this stuff. He was like, he's sitting here with his arms folded. He's like, no, next. And he just like, shoo you away.
Oh, okay, then I guess I'm done.
Oh, oh God. I'm crying. Sorry, hang on. He wants to talk.
When she starts laughing, forget it. Kuthumi can't get a word in edgewise because Keleena starts laughing, so we may be here.
Well, you guys don't see the visions, the visuals he puts in my third eye are so
Well,
he's capping
really
his
good
fingers
at telling
now.
Us. He's really good at telling us what the telling me what the vision is. He'll just show me, oh, he just showed me this, and then we just start laughing. And we'll laugh for a half hour
God.
For some of the
oh.
stuff that he shows us. It's the funniest. Okay.
All right, Keleena, are you settled now? I love that she is in her vibrations of love and joy. It makes me feel good.
It's true.
I'm sure. All right. Francois, what do you need to know about Francois that you don't already know, my dear?
Well, I don't need to know anything. I just thought you might want to throw in your dollars worth. Inflation, you know.
My dollars worth? Oh.
Well, it used to be a penny's worth and then a dime's worth and then a quarter's worth, so I pushed it up to a dollar's worth.
Well,
is
I think we're
anything?
Moving to gold now, are we not? Because the money is not worth anything anymore. Let's start saying a gold money.
Well, okay. Okay, so why don't you throw a lot of gold in? How's that?
Is all there... right, let me see. Francois, yep, yep, I'm viewing his life. Oh, he was a very good little boy. All right, let's see. Did he used to smoke?
Yes.
Yeah, I know, I see him smoking.
Now?
When he was younger, when he was younger.
Oh.
I thought he was cool. Yes. Let me see. You know those Frenchmen and their cigarettes and their wine and cheese. And he liked to break the bread. He still likes to break the bread. I see that. He likes bread. Let me see. Yep, he looks like a normal human being. What else can I say? Holding a glass of wine and flying a kite.
Oh,
my shoulder. Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh, I'm crying. Okay. Oh, God, I'm so glad that we do this radio instead because I cry every time and I'm a mess. All right. What do you want to know? Tell me.
Well, he has a concern because I'm getting a roommate, and it happens to be a man. And this is so interesting. Well, wait a minute. Wait a minute. You gotta get the point. I don't know
no,
if you really see what I'm 65, and he's 56. Pardon? In human years, yes. I've gone around the...
65 times. 11 and 11. 65, 11, 56, 11. Oh, is that what you're worried about? 11 and 11?
Well, no, he's worried because the roommate is a man and he's 50. And I started laughing because if anybody should have a concern, it's me because Francois is 9 years younger than me. So I don't know why his concern is coming up because I have no interest in the
new roommate.
Well, it is the same reason any man in the human form would be concerned if they love you. Because, you see, sometimes they are not truly out of ego. And if you're in ego and you have that little jealousy, but he calls it concern, concern is another word for jealousy. So I'm concerned, but really behind the scenes, he's jealous. Do you see what I'm saying? You don't want another man in your life.
Well,
he is far away from you. He doesn't know what's going on. He cannot see.
That's true. And we're hoping to be together before September.
All right. And may I ask you why you're hoping and why you're just not planning?
Oh, I'm planning. I'm doing research on France and all of that. It's just called money.
May I ask you a question? Why must you research France?
Well,
why don't you just go?
Money.
No, that's not what I'm saying. Universe will bring you money if you open yourself up to receiving, my dear. Okay? But why do you need to take the time to sit around and research France when you will go there and experience it?
Well, I just wanted to learn some of their culture that's totally different than ours in the USA.
Yes. But won't Francois bring that to you?
True, but for example, here, we're huggers. We hug strangers. Just hug. There, they don't like being hugged. And that took me by surprise. So
they
like
it, did you say?
A lot of them do not hug strangers.
Right.
They'll kiss you on the cheek. Right. Mm-hmm. So
they'll pass their germs another way. Yes.
Yes.
Kiss
so I told him to let his friends know that I'll kiss him on the cheeks, but then expect to get a hug. So.
All right. All right. So you're understanding their culture that way. I understand that, but you know what? The more that you are spending time researching this rather than just talking to him personally, you're wasting time.
True.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And you could be moving yourself forward and your journey forward instead of wasting time researching.
Well,
you can be there before September.
I'd love to be there. I'd love to be there right now.
Oh, of course.
He seems to be very reserved. He's not always open to sharing his feelings.
All right.
And so the phrase here is it's like pulling teeth to try to get some information out of him sometimes.
All right. He's a man. A human man.
Yay!
Well, okay, so I will give that to you is that he is a human man and he has not stepped truly in his full spiritual self yet, you see. Because those that have the balance of the feminine and masculine energy. And when you're in balance, you will open yourself up.
Okay.
Because if you understand, and you ladies, I believe, will agree, the feminine like to talk about their feelings, their emotions, what's going on. They like to give information, especially you, Deborah. You talk a lot. And
thank you.
You <Lynn.
laughs> Thanks a lot. Check out your day. Okay.
You're welcome. And the masculine are quite the opposite. They tend to step back and hold it within. Am I true? Am I right?
Yes.
All right. Well, see, there just shows you that he is just not in his balance yet.
Okay.
Make sense?
Oh, yes.
The more he opens up, the more he will step into balance. So, in other words, the subject of the show is about clearing a past life. So he has some clearing to do to get himself into balance.
Okay. Okay. Have I done pretty good on clearing?
Well,
that's not good.
I guess I'm mute for that one.
Sorry.
He just showed you flat. He just showed you flat on the floor, laying under the moon. I don't know why you showed me.
Say that again.
He just showed you flat on the floor, laying out in the field under the moon. I don't know why. Oh, clearing. He wants you to clear out the full moon. Oh my God, Kuthumi. But
did you what?
Oh my God.
No, he was showing you laying down on the ground, looking up under the moon.
Hey, if this was an old dirt and rock here, I would be happy to do this. But this is high desert. There's really
Who cares?
Places.
We must be grateful that you have something to lay on. Take a blanket.
I would. Okay.
All right. So you just need to understand that you still have some clearing that you must do, but I'm going to say one more time. Do not spend your time wasting it away on researching what's going on in France, on researching their cultures. Talk to him. And the more you talk to him and ask him questions, so slowly he will begin to open, and it will start to bring him more into balance, you see. You do not have to force him to answer your questions. You can just say, I have a question. Can you help me with it? And when you put it in that way, in that term, will you assist me with it? Will you help me with this question? I'm trying to learn this. That is when a man will step up and say yes.
Okay.
You see? Because he feels like he is giving in that regard. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And when he's giving and he's feels that he is teaching you something and you're taking that information. He's giving, you're taking. And that balance starts. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So then in return, you are very thankful and you will say, I am so thankful for the information that you have given me. I have learned so much. And he says, thank you. And in return, he is receiving that love back from you. Because when he was teaching you, you were taking, he was giving you love, and you're giving love back in your thankfulness. Does that make sense?
Okay. Yes.
So you're opening him up more, you're opening yourself up more, and you're opening the relationship up more to be very harmonic.
Okay.
Harmony is balance.
Okay.
So don't waste your time on the internet researching things.
Okay.
You want to close the gap on your union, correct?
Yes.
And to get it to move forward faster.
Okay.
Do these things together. Don't do them sitting for 5 hours on the computer by yourself and then, I have an hour to talk to him now. No.
Okay.
Spend that time talking to him.
Okay.
It's that simple. Again, it is simple. And the more you do it, guess what happens? You're in love, you're in joy, and you're in flow, my dear. And that's when the universe says, send her the money. It's time for her to go.
Make sense? Oh, definitely. Yeah. I like that. So
I love it.
Why did you bring up me getting rid of the cat?
Because last time you talked, I remember talking to you. And you said you weren't moving it because you had the cats. And you said, I don't know if I'm going to do with the cat. I'm still here because I have the cat. And I told you last time, find somebody that will take the cat and love them like you do.
Okay. That's all. I have somebody that will take them and love them.
Perfect.
So that's, I just have to do what you suggested that I do to get our relationship. What was the term? Did you use? Sorry, I forgot.
In union, towards
in
union.
Towards
in
union.
Harmonic relationship, in flow, in harmony, in balance.
Okay.
It's about the balance, it truly is.
Okay. Okay, because one of the things I have to do when I'm guilt flying to France, I have to stop where Kalina lives, so we have a day to go shopping, so she can help me pick out the makeup and put it on my face.
She is going to teach you makeup? Oh, that is wonderful, because she has done makeup on me. Oh, you should see how good I look. I'm not going to get a word in edgewise tonight.
No, you're not going to get to talk, sorry.
Oh. Good, then, yeah, stop here in Ohio on your way. It's probably on your way to JFK anyway. You could stop here, and I will come and get you.
I'll meet you guys up there.
It will be fun, and I will go, too. Don't worry, I will pick out a dress.
I want. Okay, so you brought up the dress. I want it either buttoned down all the way or that you just untie it and it falls off.
Oh, my God. Do not tell me that stuff. I do not need to know. Don't do that if we put the vision in my head.
Well, there needs more than one day, girl. We'll have to do at least 2 days' worth.
All right, that'll be fun. And you think he's not going to be here? He's going to be here.
No, he can be there. He can say, no, not that dress. Or go get that one and try it on.
Oh, no. I only wear golden robes and turbans. Well, sometimes I wear rubber
gloves.
No,
for me.
Yes,
I...
What? I missed that. Where's turban?
No, I will not say yes or no on a dress. That is a woman's area of expertise, not mine. I just look and I go, mm-hmm, yes, okay. Keleena doesn't like to wear clothes, so I'm not used to that. So I just say, mm-hmm, yes, okay.
Well, I don't like wearing clothes either, so. But, you know, at
I
the
think...
moment.
Oh, my God. Thanks.
Okay. Question. Oh, my gosh. Cindy, where are you again? You're in Sedona, right?
Sedona, Arizona area. I get to drive to the Red Rocks when I go to work.
Okay.
Okay, well,
Cindy,
I would like to say thank you for your call because we have a bunch of people waiting to talk to Kuthumi.
Yes. Okay.
When you're coming, you let me know, and we will go shopping. Well, Keleena and I will go shopping, and I will just stand there with Archangel Michael, and we'll I watch him put the little blue veil around you, girl.
Okay.
In the background.
Thank you very much.
All
right,
I'll meet
Cindy.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. Now, I'm not sure if I think I might have to just go on to the next person. We have, let me see.
Yeah.
Now it just says Jeanette.
Yes, hello. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Jeanette.
Hi, how are you? Thank you so much for this evening. I'm just so full of joy right now. It's what a great way to end off the week. It's just been.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear that.
Yes, it's lovely. Really, really lovely.
Oh, wonderful. Well, how can we help you today, or what would you like to talk about?
She wants to talk to me.
Oh, my God.
Hello, Miss Kuthumi.
Hi, how are you?
I am quite well, thank you. I am always well.
Oh, well, I have, oh, my gosh, where do I start? I have a couple
I do not
of questions.
Know.
Okay. Well, I'm going to start with a question that I've been wondering about. So, you know, there's lots of great advice out there for us on this twin flame path. And one of the things that I've been hearing is that, you know, it's really important for us to tell our beloved that we actually love them to speak our truth. But also there's this notion of divine timing with everything, right? So
right.
I'm a bit confused about, you know, there's sort of what I've been picking up that's out there floating around in the community is that it's so important to say that to the person, but if I don't feel I can do that at this point. So, but I do believe in divine timing. So I guess I'm a bit confused about the advice.
All right. Before you say anything, Deborah, may I say something about this?
Yeah, sure.
And Keleena, do you mind if I say something?
He knew I was going to jump right in there on that one.
I know. That's why I'm going to stop you. Keleena, I'm going to speak. Go on. All right.
there is a lot of stuff written out in all of the different communities, not just the twin flame community, but the light worker community and the wayshore community and the communities about the foods and everything. And remember that a lot of things are written from people's own belief systems. They have created these things from their own beliefs, okay? You must follow your heart. You must stay in your heart, your sacred heart center, and in your own knowing and standing in your own power, not listening to what everybody else says, you're going to come up with the answers for yourself.
Yes.
I believe that Kalina and Deborah talk about that all the time, about standing in your power, which means staying in your own beliefs, what you feel. You follow your own knowing. You don't not have to always look for outside advice. Because when you get to the point of, as where Deborah was earlier in the show, where Kalina and I assisted her with some clearing, that's when you can have additional help. But you must remember, use discernment. It is so very important right now because there are so many people out there that we call false prophets that are trying to lead you off your path. Okay? So please, if you're in your heart center and you know where your high heart is, do you? Yes?
I think so. I hope so.
It's by the heart. There's the heart chakra and there's the sacred heart there. It's in the chest area. Have you worked with your chakras yet?
I had clearing done by Kalina on
Perfect.
Yes.
No, perfect. So she opened it, didn't she?
Yes, she did.
Yes, I see it right now. I'm actually looking and viewing it. So the heart chakra, you know exactly where it is. She opened it there. I'm looking at what she's doing and what she did. Okay. When you step into that centeredness, that sacred heart center, and you ask yourself the question that you just asked us, do that right now. I want you to ask that question. First, I want you to go in that heart space. Okay? Feel yourself from there, not in the ego. Now ask out loud the question.
Whether I should I tell my beloved that I love him? I believe he already knows.
All right.
That's how I feel.
Do you speak with him?
Sometimes. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Not so much.
Sometimes. Hmm? Not so much.
I know. So,
I think we have a strong connection in the 5D, but in the 3D, the situation is complicated. So,
of course. There are many like that.
So, we know each other, but we don't know each other, if you know what I mean. I feel that we have a strong harmony and a strong connection, but in the actual 3D, you know, there's a language barrier and also
it makes it hard, doesn't it?
Yes, and he's very far away. Far away. So
different time zone.
Exactly, yeah.
I see.
So it's very difficult. And I only get to see him maybe once or twice a year.
But that is once or twice a year more than other people do.
Yes.
There are so many people out there that have never even, they've known of their twins all their life, and they've never met them yet in person, but they know who they are. So that's something to be
grateful. Oh, I'm very grateful. So grateful. Yes. So grateful.
So, and when you saw him, and when you're with him, do you say, I love you?
To him, to no, I don't.
Oh my
no.
God!
I see it inside.
Oh God!
I see it inside, but
the Kuthumi is going to fall over and have a heart attack, and I'm not even human. What? Oh my God! What? I'm sorry.
I haven't been able to say to him. I write it in text messages, but I say that I love him and his family.
Wait, stop. I'm going to roll back. Hold on. You've seen him in person once or twice a year. You did not say, I love you?
No.
Is Kuthumi not doing his job right? Do I need to leave now? Oh, my God, I think I'm failing. Oh.
It's a complicated situation.
Oh, I have please. I'm going to say something right now to all of you.
Okay.
Whether it is a relationship that is of a twin flame or a relationship that is of a boyfriend, girlfriend, or a lover, or a husband, wife, or even family or children, if you feel you love someone, you express it. Express it. You lift the vibrations of that other person. And not only that, sometimes people have an insecurity if they do not feel because they did not hear the word. That is many times a barrier breaker for lots of you in these relationships. If you can't say, I love you, and you're holding it back because you feel it's not the divine timing, I think we have a problem. Wait, let me call God. Let me get him on the phone and her. There's two of them. Alpha and Omega, please come in. Oh, my God. We just showed them picking up cell phones. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God. I must be clear, everybody.
Right.
I'm bringing this to you in love, and I'm bringing this to you in the highest vibration. Love is the highest energetic vibration there is. And if you feel it, say it. Don't hold it back. It does not matter if you're in a complicated relationship. Those are terms. Those are words. And we all define our own words, don't we, Deborah? She's muted herself.
Sorry, I did mute myself.
I know. I know what you're doing over there.
I know you do. You always know.
We define our own words. Complicated is a word, and that is a negative word. So take it out of your dictionary that's in your head right now and go in your heart and stay in that sacred heart center. If you love someone, do you tell them, Deborah? Unmute yourself, Mickey.
I'm unmuted. I'm just trying to decide what exactly are you speaking of.
If you love someone, do you tell them?
Yeah.
All right. Keleena, if you love someone, do you tell them? Absolutely. Although I've told people I love them and many of them have run away. Sorry, because I have a man talking through me. Well, yes, then I will keep you all to myself. But I am going to tell everybody right now, I am not Kalina's twin. Please do not think that. I am a guide of hers. That is all. But I'll keep her since nobody else wants her. I'll make her happy. She's saying.
Nobody else wants her.
Nobody wants me. I'm getting slammed tonight. Oh, my
hey,
God. Do not
join
the
club.
Slammed.
Join the club. Now you know how I feel.
All right. My dear Jeanette.
Yes.
There is divine timing and there is divine plan. That, yes, you planned things. But you've already met this person. The meeting was the plan. But when you hold back things that you feel for someone, you hold back the entire process. Does that make sense? You yourself hold yourself back and you hold the flow back. So
right.
Guess what? You have some clearing to do, my dear.
Yes, that's what I was going to say.
Yes. So yes. You need to go within and figure out what the fear is that you have.
Right.
that you don't want to tell him. Remember, everything is an illusion around you. You say things are complicated. Nothing is complicated. Mm-hmm. Everything is simple. Everything is part of the process, and it's part of your transformation. The transformation right. for you. You're the most important person.
Okay. Tonight, you were talking about past lives, so could my blockage be from past lives?
Has Keleena talked to you about past lives when she worked with you?
She did some light language clearing. But I...
Do you remember what she brought up?
Not so much. Yes, there was some light language that was done on my heart center for sure. Mm-hmm.
Did she talk about your childhood? A childhood past
yes.
life? Yes, she did. I'm seeing it right now.
Yes.
Yes, you remember now that I said it, don't you? Mm-hmm. Keleena has lots of clients, so she probably doesn't know exactly which one you are because she has a couple Jeanettes, but I am looking right now and reviewing what she did with you. She brought up a childhood
mm-hmm.
past life situation.
Mm-hmm.
So review it again. This is Venus retrograde. Go back
right.
into that and view it again. If you need more assistance, maybe you need to seek Keleena again. Because if you do not go within and go deeper and deeper to the root and clear this out, pull out the core and get it out of you, you're not going to move forward. You're going to continue to hold yourself back. And only you hold yourself back, nobody else.
Right. Right.
It is that simple.
I understand. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
You are welcome. So welcome.
Keleena Kuthumi, can you check your microphone? I don't know if it's just me, but it sounds like it's a little muted. So just see if it's tucked in your hair. Sometimes the microphone gets in your hair.
Nope, it's not in my hair. Is it still muted?
No, it's better. Yeah, it's better now.
All right. That's because I had my hand over it.
Oh, you had your hand over it?
Mm-hmm.
You're muting yourself then, Kuthumi.
All right, Jeanette, is there anything else, my dear?
No. Thank you so much. I want to get to you tonight. Thank you so much again. I'll be listening. It's such a delight.
Thank you, Jeanette. Thank you so much for
calling
in. Bye,
Jeanette.
Thank you so much, Debbie. Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, we're going to go ahead and take the next call, I believe, is.
I must have a bathroom break. 1 minute.
You do? A bathroom break? Are you kidding? Well, I'm bringing on the next caller. You're just going to have to wait. And the caller is Michelle.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
How are you?
Hello. I'm good.
Yeah.
I think that Kuthumi's been following me around this week, though, really.
I follow everybody around.
Yeah,
I've got about 3 billion souls that I follow around. Don't think you're special.
No, I don't.
I don't think you're special.
I am just kidding. Everybody is special in my book.
Okay.
It's a good thing you don't have Ganesh as your ascended master. He's pretty rough. He just showed Ganesh with a whip.
Oh,
good thing you don't do that to me. Oh,
hi,
all
Michelle.
Right,
what's
Michelle.
Going on with you tonight?
Well, I'm a little bit in the same kind of state that you were in when you started explaining what was going on with you this week.
Oh, boy, here we go. All right. Bring it on. It's a challenge for Kuthumi. Go on.
I've come like so far with all of this, and a big thing for me was being triggered with my twin flame, and it hasn't happened in months and months and months where it's really, really been like a big trigger. So I had a trigger, and I just like started like I guess I just start like Keleena says, speaking my truth, and of course he doesn't really want to hear that. And now he's completely shut down. And I kind of realized I went back and I started thinking about the last time that it was Venus retrograde. and there was such a similar episode. And no, it's basically like he just shuts down.
Okay.
And
okay.
I'm not asking him to do anything. That's just what the thing is. I just don't want him to like ignore it. And you know, and I tell him, you don't have to do anything. You don't have to change your life, nothing. But just, you know, acknowledge. It's just very difficult.
He presses his own button.
I'm getting information. Can I speak?
Oh, good God.
Can I
have I'll just sit back here and have some popcorn. Go on.
Usually Kuthumi will say that to me. Can I have permission to speak? Not tonight, he didn't. No, I'm kidding.
This is my debut. Go on, Deborah. I will allow it.
No, speaking your truth. All right, Michelle, think about this. You're standing in your truth. You're speaking your truth. But guess what you're still doing? You're still asking for his permission, as opposed to speaking your truth and saying, now you can take it and do what you will with it, even if that means shutting down.
Yeah, well, that's what we got.
Well, guess what? As long as you, but see, that's the part that needs the work. It's not you speaking your truth. It's that you being okay with speaking your truth, not to get a reaction that you're looking for. In other words, one of the things that I realized as I started working with people is as you start stepping into your truth, you literally have the ability to say, this is what I feel. This is where I'm coming from. Now, I'm going to give that to you, and I'm going to let you go. Do what you will with it. It doesn't matter to me what you do with it. It just means I've said it. I feel good, and that's it.
Well, that is what I did. The kind of like the last thing that I sent, I said, you know, I'm just expressing this, and I'm not asking for anything. I'm not asking, you know, for you to change your life, none of that. Just
correct.
I'm just asking for some understanding.
Which
I'm still asking for something.
For?
I get it.
Yep. You're still asking for something. You know, it reminds me of a situation. I'll just, without getting into specifics of who and what, but, you know, all right, you're in a situation, I'm trying to think, because this is very, very specific to a particular situation of someone that's very close to me. All right, so it's someone I'm very close to, and she has a twin, and her twin was doing some things that were really, really upsetting her, all right? And she went and she just said, this is how I feel, da, 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 da. And then she walked away. And then it was kind of like I was trying to show her that's all there is to it. Just say what you've got to say. There's nothing more to the equation. To stand in your truth is only to say what has to be said from your own heart. In other words, if it's your need to say it, that you feel free to say it, and then you really, the lesson for you is, okay, now I've said it. That was all I needed to express it. If you find yourself wanting something in return for it, you got more work to do on it.
I know. You know, the thing is, too, is that it's just because we are on the once-a-year plan, so
yeah.
It's just, it
Ooh,
makes
I like
it more.
That term.
And that's one of the questions that I have, too, that I had from the beginning when you started the radio show, is how to deal with that, because when you're in that kind of situation and someone comes and spends 5 days with you and everything's beautiful and wonderful and they're making plans about how they might move to your city and this, that, and the other, and then suddenly they're just shut down. It's just so difficult.
Well,
and then that's a big trigger for me. Like, I can't say this person does anything else except not respond to me sometimes. He's never done anything that I could say he's doing this and complain so much about him. It's nothing like that, but it's just awkward for me to be in one space and then it just like changes.
Well, the thing that I have found in these relationships, for the lack of a better word, these connections, is that the reason why this happens is because if that person was doing all of these things in your life and all this stuff the way would be nice to have, you would not learn what you're learning when they're withdrawing your energy. So
that's
as long
true.
As you need them to give you anything, they're going to withdraw. So you're in any kind of connection and you have a need, as soon as they feel the need, they got to step back because you have to fulfill all your own needs.
So these there's different circumstances, but in your particular case, since you are in a situation where you only see each other every once in a while, what you have to understand is there's a brilliantly designed plan to all of this. So if you're only together once a year, it means that's what your soul said to you.
How ridiculous does that sound, you know? Like, when they say like twin flames is a certain thing that would be a deal breaker with anybody else, that's so, so true.
Who said that?
Yes. And the reason why, I don't know who said that. Who said that? Was that good to me?
Yes. Who said that? That's what I would like to know. Who told you that and why did you believe
you that?
Okay, I don't believe it. I'm sorry. I saw it in some groups.
Belief systems. Go on.
Yeah.
I'm listening.
We got lots of belief systems.
I'll make up for what Deborah doesn't cover.
Okay, that sounds good. Whatever I don't cover, you got me covered. All right.
I got it. I got your back, they say, in human terms.
Thank you. I appreciate you. All right. So, but you're in a situation where you only see each other once a year, and you get into this place where everything is wonderful and comfortable and cozy for 5 days, and he talks about moving to your city and stuff like that. Now, if that were to move forward, and he were to move to your city, and he was to continue on that connection, what would happen to you?
I don't know. I could honestly say I don't know, because everything about this has been a surprise up to now.
Okay. Well, I can tell you just from the experiences I've seen with myself and other people, if you had that person just step in and follow through and do all these things, you know what's going to happen? You're going to fall into old world relationship templates.
So we were already in a situation where he was here, and we were, like, together like a quote-unquote couple, and I was pretty much, like, acting like old relationship templates, yes.
Right.
Because you are not
exactly
ready. Neither of you are ready.
Right, exactly. So the soul knows what you need to shift in order for you to move into this new connection of love. And the new connection of love can have no old relationship templates, no old expectations, no old patterns, no codependencies. Unfortunately, most of the relationships on the planet right now are codependent.
Mm-hmm.
I would say 90% of the relationships, just coming to me, 90 across my forehead, Kalina, 90% at least are codependent. What we're trying to break, as you want to say, the sacred twins, whatever, you know, what we're trying to break here is that old templated dependent relationship. So if your soul knows that you being together more than once a year is going to create that codependency, then guess what? You're not going to allow yourself to come together until you're ready, until neither one of you is going to fall into that same codependent groove that you were born into, a groove coming in through your family line. So as you're in that family line, and so is he, you both have to break your own individual family line grooves, if you will, to be together. And so the amount of time you spend with that person is probably, and I'm just conjecturing here, it's probably in direct relation to what your soul knows that you can handle in order to, and the triggers, so that you will have the time that you need to grow into that independent being with no codependency. And you'll continue to test getting closer and closer and closer, and you'll be tempted to get more and more codependent, and you're going to have to back off until you come together, and it's like, oh, I don't need you, you don't need me, we love being together, we are
in our own power. He doesn't need me. No, he has no codependent issues when it comes to me, only when it comes to his own life situation. That's his codependency.
Well, but there you go. It doesn't matter.
Right.
It doesn't matter how that codependency exhibits. He's actually the opposite of you, right?
Mm-hmm.
He is absolutely, because I know your situation a little bit, he's absolutely not codependent on you, but he's codependent on the substitute for that feminine aspect.
Right.
So, there you go.
Okay, so that was good.
Well, Kuthumi, now
a lot to think about.
Kuthumi's probably got something to say, too.
Okay.
I'm
going to
just say, go for
it. Oh, wait, I was online shopping. Okay, are you done talking?
You were not. You were online shopping. It's your
Get your yellow turban back in the room.
Oh.
Yes.
All right. Ask me a question. Ask me a question.
You weren't even listening, were you, Kuthumi?
I did listen, but I want to say that there's so many things that I would like to say back to her that are different than what you said.
Right.
Because first of all, let me remind you once again that the things you read and you hear other people say, many of them that are not way showers and that are not here to teach about the twin flame process are writing or talking about their own personal experience, and it will not be the same as yours. I cannot stress that enough. There are certain people that are here to help assist with the twin flames, and there are others that they're not, that they will write about their, they will express, may I say, in writing about what they've gone through. But it's not going to be the same as yours. It is not comparable. As each person's emotions and the memories are different and the things that they need to clear are different. Everyone is different. Every relationship is different. And everyone's clearing will be different. So, what you said, the first thing that you said, well, so-and-so is sad, and we're, you know, bah. Yeah, well, so what? Let it go, because you know what? You're going through your own process of transformation. Now, everybody, I know Keleena has said this too, is that, and Deborah, I believe you have, is when the twin flames come together, or when they meet, it is to assist with the ascension process, correct? You've said this too, Deborah and Keleena?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I believe it's part of awakening.
Yeah.
And to assist, like, that push to get you to start moving forward. So, all right. So, Michelle, you have had your awakening and your push to move forward spiritually. But all souls did not come here to do this as twin flames. Maybe you came down as twin flames, okay? But I'm going to say this. You're doing this in a singularity. Yes, you're pressing each other's buttons and triggers and whatever you wish to call it so that you can move forward in your process. But you still are in singularity. This is a soul ascension. Does this make sense so far? This is a soul ascension. This is not.
Well, yeah. So basically, I don't have to have him in the physical to experience joy, like what your message is.
Of course not. Everybody brings themselves joy, but this
right.
is a soul ascension, a transformation process of the soul of the part that you are carrying. You are doing your own work for you. He is doing his own work for him. And right now, he's not ready to do that work.
No.
I'm viewing him right now. And what I see is him sitting at a desk with his hands on his head. Because he right now is stuck in ego with his line of work and
mm-hmm.
with what has been brought to him from you and him together. It is a hard shift for him, would you say?
Impossible, almost.
Yes, I see that. So, it is a big, big shift that he will have to make if he chooses to leave his, I will not say anything else, I will just say his work, that's all I will say.
Uh-huh.
His position in his work is what I will say. And let me make sure I do not say this so that I point fingers. His transformation process is going to be hard. And there's a few that have chosen that same line of work that are going through this like he is. Okay? You understand what I am saying.
I do understand. And I feel like I like the mission that I would want to do would just be so more powerful together than apart. And that's what part of my, because I really don't want just that romantic thing. I know it sounds like, but I don't. I really want that mission. I do.
I want you to stop.
Okay.
Your soul, the part that you came down to play, the role that you came down to play, okay, you feel it is one way because it's in your ego that you're helping assist with that, when actually that is his part of the transformation,
mm-hmm.
to bring down that template. But yours is different, my dear.
Okay.
And you must go within and find it. You haven't thought of that, have you?
Nope. That's good, I have to say.
Perfect. Because that is his area that he must focus on and he came to work on. That is
right.
His template and his past pattern and belief systems that he must take care of. That is his singularity. That is his soul's ascension. That is the work he came to do. Yours is different.
Okay.
And many people will say, oh, we came down to do the same work. Well, no. Yes, you may be coming down and having work that is co-creation. Absolutely. Yours is a little different. You're in a different system versus his.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the system you work in, my dear. You chose that for a reason. Do you understand now?
Mm-hmm.
Have you
yes, I do. That,
that
was very helpful.
All right. Have you thought that maybe? Look what you've been blessed with in your life. A beautiful young lady that you've been blessed with in your life, and I will say nothing else.
Mm-hmm.
And how do you feel when you are with that person?
Love well, she's more important to me than even the twin flame, definitely.
But she brings love and joy, doesn't she?
Absolutely.
All right. Maybe your focus is on that venue. Do you see? And when you focus on that, look at it this way. You're assisting this one person, and you can assist so many more that are in that kind of a situation. And guess what? Is that almost like the kind of thing that he's doing, but differently?
Right.
And together, the co-creation could come together because it is humanitarian, maybe?
Uh-huh.
All right. What he came to do, the patterns he came to break, and the templates are his own. And you have yours. Look at her situation and look at what you can do, maybe a plan that you can devise to assist others in her situation or to assist others that need someone like you, if that makes sense.
Right, yes, absolutely.
All right, very good. So I don't remember what your question was, but I needed to tell you what Keleena shows me.
No, that was good for my question. That was awesome.
All right. Is there anything else?
That's it, guys. Thank you so much.
Great,
because
hey, I need a drink
Michelle.
Of water.
Okay.
Ah. Now,
bye-bye.
I'll be following you.
Okay.
Kuthumi, I have a question for Kuthumi.
Oh, no.
Hang on a second.
Okay.
Really, no. Okay. Now, all right. So you and I have both, we both talked with Michelle. And
yes.
When I was talking to Michelle about her connection and
which
the,
one? Okay.
Well, the connection with her and her twin,
mm-hmm.
I was talking about how, you know, you might not come together because of the fact that you are trying to work on templates of that nature. Did I totally misspeak? Am I coming out of a belief system that doesn't exist? Or is that a belief system? 'Cause, you know,
I will be honest with you, Deborah. I did not
yes.
listen to what you were saying.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that makes me feel a little bit better. Well, when you first
sure.
started out, you said, you know, listening to what other people in the community say, and you shouldn't listen to what other people in the community say because everybody has their own story. I didn't know if that discounted everything that I said to her.
No, that was not about what you. No, that did not. That was not about what you were talking about. That was about what she brought up first when she said,
okay.
people are saying that it should be this way. It is not like that because
gotcha.
Everybody's
okay.
experience
I just
is
wanted
different.
To be sure because
don't worry, I was
I
not
felt
picking
pretty,
on you.
No, I'm not saying picking on me. I just mean
I wanted to be sure that I was not under a belief system. I mean, obviously, all belief systems are just that. But I feel
listened
pretty...
to you, Deborah, and you did well. I just let it go because you were on the right track. But we only, Keleena shows me in her third eye, and I show her things in her third eye, you see. So she showed me Michelle's situation.
Right.
And I took from that. And that's where we bring in the information more in detail.
Right.
Your stuff
is
very good to teach and to help others that need assistance in this general manner. So it was
right. No,
perfect.
That was absolutely amazing. I just wanted to make sure that I had not misspoken, that I had not given information that was not helpful. Do you see what I'm saying?
And are you worrying, Deborah?
Yes, of course.
Can you go in your heart, please?
Yes, I'm going into my heart.
Stay in the heart. If I was going to say that you said something wrong, first of all, I would never say that. I would ask you a question and make you...
I know you would.
...talk it out, wouldn't I?
Yeah.
Everything is fine. Okay, thank you, Michelle. I'll be following you around, and we'll have a bottle of wine together. I'll bring Yeshua. Okay, next call.
Next call.
Michelle, you drinking.
All right,
drinking,
here we go. We are going to go to Elizabeth.
Hi.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
You're good.
I'm fine, thanks.
Good.
Hello,
how can we help you today? What would you like to talk about?
I have a question about a part of the process that I feel like doesn't get addressed a lot in the communities, and I've been trying to navigate kind of on my own. You know, I've had a few sessions. I had a session with Keleena, and I've had a couple with Jill and Remy. And I just, sometimes I hit this roadblock. Kind of just overcame one today, and I wanted to call in and ask about it, which is that in the process of coming into union with your twin, which is the process that I'm in right now, I sometimes struggle with knowing if I'm really learning the process of like open-hearted detachment. So I guess that's the basis of my question, is trying to understand kind of better what that is, because what happens with us is, you know, we have the kind of triggers that come up, and I think we work through them really well, and we're very honest and open with each other. And I just, because of, I think, my own wounding, you know, I have a tendency to kind of detach maybe in not the right way, or kind of go more into indifference in that process. And I guess I can't tell if I'm like operating from my heart center, or like I just get confused about exactly, you know, navigating some of the 3D things and any decisions that need to be made. You know, we've never had like a full-blown separation. We've had kind of major issues that come up. It's like a day that we take separate, and then we kind of work through it real quick, and then tend to kind of come back together. So I guess my question is just basically like trying to find information about what exactly open-hearted detachment is and how I know if I'm doing
well. I was going to say, I've never really heard, I'm having a reverberation. Are you on a speakerphone, or...
I'm on my computer because I couldn't get my phone to work, and I have my headphone plugged in, but I could try and plug in my
headphone. Okay, do you have your speakers on?
I don't. It's like plugged in with my headphone.
Oh, okay. All right, well, it's not reverberating now. I was hearing like myself in full sentences. I'd like to know, just if I could, just a little bit about that, the term that you're talking about. I've never heard that term before.
I guess it's something that I hear from some of the teachers in the community, where it's basically the idea, I believe, where, you know, you sort of just live in the moment for what you have with the person, and you surrender your attachment to the outcome.
So what did you call it, though? You called it
open-hearted detachment, where you, like, love...
Detachment,
mm-hmm.
Okay.
And you love the person with an open heart, and you allow yourself to be vulnerable, which is kind of my main issue, and something that the union process has really helped me with. And he's been very helpful with me with that. But I think that's the open-hearted part, but then that you also detach from, you know.
Right. I just had never heard it called that, so I just was trying
because
to get my mind.
May I interject, please?
Yes.
I'm going
yeah.
to stress this again, if you don't mind. This
yeah.
is another term that is made up on your earth plane from those that feel they are teaching. So we know what they're going
mm-hmm.
to do. They're going to throw a whole new term in there,
mm-hmm.
and they're going to suck you in.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? Oh, I need to go running to this person because they've discovered something different.
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what? No. There is
mm-hmm.
detachment,
mm-hmm.
and there is the open heart.
Okay.
Now they put them together to make it sound like there's a whole new different level
mm-hmm.
when there is not. Remember
mm-hmm.
what I said earlier. Use discernment.
Mm-hmm.
And words are words. And we define our own words. And these new terms are going to keep coming up because people are going to be like, how am I going to suck them in to come over here? And how am I going to suck them in to come over here? And as I said before, there are many false prophets out there. There are many that are making monetary gain on this.
Mm-hmm.
And I am not joking when I say that.
Mm-hmm.
There are many out there claiming that, and I'm going to say this right now, many are going to listen to this and they need to hear it. There are other people that are claiming that they are channeling people. And when they are claiming they are channeling people, they're claiming that these people they're channeling, like Jesus and Mary, and Jesus and Mary are telling everybody to buy their book because they are the only twins around or the only twins alive on the earth. I am sorry, but I have reviewed that. Jesus and Mary would never tell you to go buy someone's book, okay? This is the kind of situation you are dealing with on your earth plane right now.
Mm-hmm.
So be very careful.
Mm-hmm.
Use discernment when you see a new term. If you have not seen this before and all of a sudden it comes up and people are now starting to talk about this for 6 months, you
mm-hmm.
must question it. You must go in your own knowing. Detachment is detachment. Open heart is open heart.
Mm-hmm.
Those are two different things. It is not one thing altogether. Deborah, you can go on. I just needed to say that.
Exactly.
I must be clear.
And when I, you know, I'm glad that you did that, Kuthumi. When we were just looking at these words, the thing that kept coming to my mind when you were speaking, Elizabeth, is, you know, the whole thing about the vulnerable piece. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The vulnerable piece is the piece that wants to be cool and unattached, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why you want to be cool and unattached is because it does seem, and Kuthumi and I have talked about this before, there's a little bit of a power struggle that goes on between twins in terms of
mm-hmm.
who is more calm, cool, and collected, who is more in their heart center and, you know, things of that nature. And the vulnerable piece, it's almost as if, especially as you're starting to move into your truth and your knowing and everything else,
mm-hmm.
This is where the ego kind of sneaks in just a little bit and can fool you into thinking that you are unattached, but really you are cool, and that's to cover up the vulnerable piece, okay?
Mm-hmm.
What I think is starting to happen in that process is a fine-tuning, okay?
Yeah.
So it does sound, I'm very experienced with your situation and have worked with people that are actually have had no separations from their twin, have had that ongoing, continual working through things well. And I'll tell you, I want to take that open-hearted detachment and I want to just give it a little bit of a new, not a new spin, it's something I've talked about before, but just something that might be helpful for you.
Mm-hmm.
All right. When we talk about unconditional love,
mm-hmm.
right? I've said this before about what unconditional love means to me in my own experience, and this is me talking from my own experience. When you master your own vibration, and all I mean by mastering your own vibration is to know that you are in control of your own vibration. Now, I don't know. I'm looking here to see. You might not have been on the entire call, but in the very beginning, of the day, or our call, I was talking about how I was not mastering my own vibration today, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Now, the one thing I can say is that I have a complete awareness when I am not in my vibration, and I also, under most circumstances, know that I allow my own vibration to fall, that it's usually not outside of myself. Well, something happened to me today and yesterday, the last couple of days, where some old belief systems came in. And that's really what I can say now that I feel like I'm sitting in a higher perspective because of maybe some of the clearing I did just earlier on the call. Mm-hmm. I was exposed to some old belief systems that says when you go into a hospital and you're dealing with family and you're dealing with trauma and you're dealing with hospitals, you know, if you're not quite protected, energy can latch onto you and bring your vibrations down. And this is an old belief system, okay. All right? I did not remember that I am a great being of light, as we all are, that I can boost up my light field and my light quotients and that I'd have nothing to fear. I let some of my old fears come in. But more importantly, in terms of my own vibration, I saw in my mind's eye that something else could control my vibration, and that's projection. Projection is when you don't understand that everything that you see outside of you is caused by your belief about the situation, all right? Mm-hmm. Unconditional love is a circumstance where you are in complete awareness that you are creating your reality, which means you are the only one that's in charge of your vibrations. Mm-hmm. So let's say your vibrations fall. If you are not in unconditional love, you would say, oh, that person made me feel that way, or this circumstance made me feel that way, or, you know, that thing that person said hurt my feelings. When you're in unconditional love, you say, ah, I allowed that to hurt me because I have something inside of me that still hurts. How can I go in and help my own self and clear that and be in my own vibrational control? Do you see what I'm saying? Mastery. So you can literally raise your own vibration. And when you are able to do that and nothing outside of you really controls your vibration, it might affect you. All right. That does not mean that when someone says something that is construed as hurtful, that it doesn't hurt, but you know that it's something inside of you that caused mm-hmm. that to happen. So when you get to where you're mastering, and I'm telling you, everybody that's listening would know this, it's the mastery of this until you've really achieved that ascension into that fifth dimensional vibration that, you know, and even Kuthumi was talking about that, the fifth dimensional vibration. You don't bring this duality into that. There is no duality in there. There mm-hmm. is no, you know, ego and all that kind of stuff. You don't live from that. But until we get there, we're going to go back and forth a little bit. But mastering your vibration is at least the consciousness that you are the controller of your own vibration. Now, when you achieve that state, you are not vulnerable. And I'll tell you why. Because your twin comes in and your twin triggers you. But you're so conscious that trigger is really something you're sensitive to that you know instantly, oh, I'm sensitive to that. I need to go in. I need to shift that energy. In other words, you don't need him to do anything,
mm-hmm.
him or her. I would say him or her. You don't have to have them do anything because you can master that situation yourself. It's mm-hmm. not in the typical templated earth relationships, there's a lot of this give and take. Well, let's talk about this. This really bothers me when you do this, and this bothers me when you do that. So if you'll just stop doing this and I just stop doing that, then we're going to be okay with each other. In other words, there's a lot of negotiation. You change this bit and I'll change this bit and we'll be okay. Mm-hmm. In these new union relationships, you don't change anything in the other person. You don't ask them to be any different than they are at any given moment. They are what they are at any given moment. They don't need to be different. You know that you master that vibration yourself, even when you choose to fall in vibration, like I guess I apparently did today. Mm-hmm. I fell in vibration. So, but it wasn't anyone outside myself that created it. And so, But these are, you know, for me, it was a blip for me out of unconditional love. Mm-hmm. And I see that now, and I am so grateful. Even this conversation we're having now and the experience that I had earlier with declaring with Kuthumi, and then going back to the experience I had during my whole day where I had a lot of that, I realize now I fell out of unconditional love, not because there's anything unloving about me or that I wasn't. It was that I wasn't mastering my own vibration.
Mm-hmm.
So in your union, which is what you're working on, and you have it, you have the union, okay?
Yeah.
Let's just say that. You know, there's no such thing as being with someone for a long period of time, day in and day out, even if you take 24-hour breaks from each other.
Mm-hmm.
There's no way that a union like that is not union.
Mm-hmm.
But what you're doing is it sounds like the fine-tuning process of letting go of your final, you know, in detachment, unattached is the way I kind of like to look at it, is unattached. You're unattached to an outcome. You're unattached to what the person thinks or says or does. You're just not attached to it. The open-heartedness, you know, sometimes open-heartedness, sit in your heart center and try to make your decisions about what's in front of you from your heart instead of your head.
Yeah.
That's the process that you're going through, is to take anything that's going on in your head and put it in your heart, and to master your own vibration. As long as that's what you're working on, mm-hmm. you are right on target. Does that help?
Yeah, that helps a lot. It sort of affirms, you know, kind of what I was thinking, because that is what occurred to me today, that it felt like some fine-tuning that was going on because, like, there's some 3D stuff that's shifting that's going to allow us to, like, have more 3D union, like some of my own life circumstances. So I thought, well, this is probably related to that as well.
Well, and remember. As you unfold that, the change, mm-hmm. as you unfold that change, which sounds like you're going to be able to spend more time together, it sounds like,
mm-hmm.
This, again, It indicates to me that a lot of work has been done, but mm-hmm. it will continue. Now, if there's your situation changing, that means it's going to be a whole new set of some things to smooth and work through. It's all fine-tuning, though.
I know. I do feel like I do a pretty good job of, like, mastering my vibration, and I came to understand... Like, it's kind of interesting, I feel like, how the things are set up in my life that have helped me do that, because it's actually, mm-hmm. like, an ex who's helping me, I could say did some very awful things to me, but now I just say, like, he is my master class for teaching me about, like, mastering my vibration.
That's exactly it.
Yeah, and I understand, like, when this thing came up between me and my twin yesterday, I knew, like, I could identify what it was within me that it was triggering and give a name to it and understand it exactly and work through it. Mm-hmm. It just gets like, the part where we work on it together, and we really don't do the thing where we try to, like, make the other person change. Like, we try to allow them to be who they are and then just say, like, are we helping each other grow? Or is this still mm-hmm. working positively, you know? And
mm-hmm.
it kind of brings those things up where it's like, well, do you need to go do something else right now or not? Or, you know, does this mean that you are craving this different experience, or you want to do something different before we, you know, have more union? Or it just brings those up, I guess, with more frequency than I feel I want to deal with, you know, because most of the time we try to just be, like, really appreciative and, like, a lot of gratitude for what we do have, even though it's been mm-hmm. we've wanted more for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes it just feels like we're doing that, and then out of left field we get slammed with the most random. The triggers are so random sometimes, and they go so deep.
I totally understand that. I mean, I cannot say enough that is an experience that I can totally relate to.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get to a place where there is, you know, I see that all around me, a deepness of people that are coming together. And it's kind of like each time you're getting closer, this has to be the Venus retro, you know, the Venus retro, that there's the issues that are still sitting there.
Yeah.
And
May I say something when you're done talking, Deborah, blah, blah, blah?
Absolutely. Go for it. Go for it. I'm quiet now.
I would only like to tell Miss Elizabeth, that is a beautiful name, by the way.
Thank you.
I would like to tell you to listen to the show after Deborah and Kalina post it, repost it. Mm-hmm. There are things in the beginning that you are going to go, aha.
Okay.
You're going to listen to something that Deborah went through, mm-hmm. that we walked her through, mm-hmm. and you're going to be like, oh, do you mm-hmm. see?
Yeah, so, I think I was on for most of that. I came in, right, I think I called in 13 minutes late.
Well, that's all right then. I believe the things that Deborah is reiterating are the things that we said in the beginning, and she's learned from it.
Yeah.
And now putting it into her own words. And this is what you're going to do too.
Okay.
It's quick too. That's Look what's at how, beautiful about this process.
That's the absorption. You're going through that transformation of self, my dear.
Mm-hmm, yes.
It is truly the transformation of your own soul.
Mm-hmm.
It is the singularity. This is not something you didn't come down. People are saying that you came down. Yes, you separated in two, blah, blah, blah. All of that. But it's the transformation and singularity that is key and most important is the transformation of self for ascension.
Yeah.
It is the ascension of self.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yes. Thank you.
Very important.
Thank mm-hmm. you, Elizabeth.
Mm-hmm. No, thank you. I appreciate it.
Is there anything Thanks, else Elizabeth. That you wanted to talk about or you wanted to maybe ask it to me?
I guess I had one question, which is that, you know, sometimes I wonder if I'm doing something to make it harder than it's supposed to be, like...
Oh, my God, yes, everybody. Okay. I think I discussed this in the beginning, did I not, Deborah? Kalina? Yeah, he did.
Uh-huh.
Yes, is that everything's supposed to be done simply? Yes. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Yeah.
All right. Do I need to go over this again? Were you not on for this part?
I don't know if I was or not, but I guess I don't really understand... Like
right.
on a practical
it,
level, what needs what need right. to make then, it more simple?
Then let's do this. It is the simplicity of staying in your heart. It is mm-hmm. that simple. As we discussed in the beginning, if you're constantly thinking from the ego,
mm-hmm.
you're constantly set up there and you're in the noise, and you're going, what am I doing wrong?
Mm-hmm.
When actually you're probably not doing anything wrong. The only thing you're doing wrong is thinking. Because you need to step out of the ego and go into the heart center. I think I said this a few times on the show tonight. It is the heart center. And I know Kalina teaches this to every single client.
Mm-hmm.
You are meant to live from the heart, not mm-hmm. the head. Kalina, explain what the ego is for really quick and then I will continue. Okay, gee, I get to talk tonight. Ego. wait, I have to come down a little bit. Our ego is for our survival. That's mm-hmm. the reason that it's in the physical body. The ego is, if you are hungry and your body tells you you're hungry, the survival is you're going to eat. The same with if you're thirsty, you're going to eat. If there's a bus coming in the road, you're going to jump out of the way. That's survival. That's what the ego is meant for. It wasn't mm-hmm. meant for what we're using it for. It is because humans have disconnected themselves from their own Christ consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
They've disconnected themselves from their heart-centeredness,
mm-hmm.
from that higher state of being. They've lowered themselves into the... Because when you come in, you have to come in 3D physical form. And they stayed in that ego, which is 3D, instead of raising themselves up in that vibration and that higher state of being.
Mm-hmm.
A fifth dimensional higher. But everybody's working through that right now. And everybody is getting there. And as you get there only by doing all the inner work. So, all right, very good. Thank you, Kalina. Okay, I guess I'm done. So, all right. So, when you learn this and you can really, really stay in your heart center and remind yourself, be in the heart.
Mm-hmm.
I believe there were, I don't know, maybe 15 years ago, everybody was wearing bracelets that said, what would Jesus do?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you remember that? Does everybody remember that?
Yes.
I'm sure they do. It's the same thing because Jesus lived in his heart.
Yeah.
Well, guess what? That's where you're supposed to be living.
Mm-hmm.
So you go into that space, and everything you do, everything that you think and everything you say, every thought, every action comes from that heart center.
Mm-hmm.
And in that heart center brings simplicity. When you're up in the ego, you end up fighting yourself. Oh, maybe I should be doing it this way. Oh, no, I should be doing it this way. But so-and-so said I should be doing it this way. No. You go into your own heart space. You go into your own belief system, your own knowing, and you ask yourself from the heart, what should I be doing for this? And when you receive the answer, because you're in your own heart space, you're receiving from your higher self, and I'm sure that Keleena spoke to you on the session about this,
mm-hmm.
your highest self answers you first.
Yeah.
Because only your highest self knows the truth, your highest self, and you planned everything before you came back. The answer you received, and do not doubt it, comes from heart space.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple. Give me a question that you feel you may be doing in your terms. Not simple enough. Tell me, give me an example.
I guess my the thing that has been coming up somewhat often is like we kind of come together and say, okay, we're gonna like, you know, be together and work together and help each other, and then he'll kind of step back from the relationship a little bit and say like, oh, it's kind of a lot for me to deal with, and I know that I still have like some fear operating there of like that I'm going to be hurt by it. And so I just keep like making myself like take steps forward into vulnerability and saying, well, I'm just going to keep like being open and like offering love and trying to receive the love that he's giving me, even though I'm afraid of like what might happen with it and not focus on that. But that's kind of where I get confused with it, I guess, where I don't, you know, I feel like I'm thinking too far into the future too often or something.
Oh, right. And we are not supposed to think in the future, are we?
No.
And we're not supposed to think of the past, because the past is over and it is gone and it cannot be changed.
Yes.
We don't think of the future. We live in the now.
Mm-hmm.
And the simple answer for, all right. The simple answer to this is that you're both not ready.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, if you want to come together in union, you still have clearing to do.
Yeah.
You obviously said, I am afraid.
Mm-hmm.
What I fear is. You see, you brought those terms up yourself.
Yeah.
And if you are using those words, then you still have clearing to do.
Mm-hmm.
Because obviously you have a mentality about it, and you have an emotion that goes along with it.
Mm-hmm.
It is a step-by-step process.
Mm-hmm.
If you need continued support, then get continued support so you can get to the core of this and get rid of it.
Mm-hmm.
But this, you at least are saying you have a fear and mm-hmm. that you have a fright. Now listen, fear is a word that I ask people to get rid of.
Okay.
Okay. Nothing in this world you should fear. Nothing.
Yeah.
Because the only truth is love.
Yeah.
When you let go of the illusion of fear, because fear puts you in a state of being that is control,
yeah.
and that is ego, where mm-hmm. are you? Oh, you're back in those thought processes again.
Yeah.
Oh, good God. Here you go. You're starting all over.
Yeah.
You can't get from A to B if you keep jumping back.
No.
To the fear. You have to continue the clearing and continue going through the process to get it over with and out of your system.
Yeah.
Get out of all of your bodies. You let the emotion go. You let the mentality of the situation go.
Mm-hmm.
You find what you're feeling and why it's making you feel. You got to get deep in there.
and you find that root.
Yeah, I do.
And there's nothing wrong. And as I said early in the show to someone else, another caller, if you need assistance, oh, and maybe it was Deborah. I think it was Deborah. If you need the assistance outside of yourself for things that you cannot find, then get the assistance.
Yeah.
It is so welcome, because what it will do will assist you and push you on your journey, clear you faster, mm-hmm. and you learn from it, and you take with that so that you may help someone else.
Okay.
But don't sit back and keep going, why isn't this working?
Mm-hmm.
What am I doing wrong? Maybe he said something. Maybe I said something. Mm-hmm. You have to work on yourself. Mm-hmm. You need to get to the bottom of what's holding you back.
Yeah.
He has his own things to do.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
Yes. Yeah, it does. I guess that's what I've been doing. So I guess that's good. I've been going through that process. It just gets long and tedious, and it's you know.
Yeah.
But you know what?
I'm going to throw that word in, yeah.
There are people that have been going through this for years and years, and you know what? The ones that go through for years and years are the ones that have not sought the additional help,
mm-hmm.
because they don't know how to handle it. Or they're reading so many different things online. Oh, this person's doing this and it worked for them. This person, no, everybody's experience is different.
Yeah.
You must find someone that will assist you and find and pinpoint what it is for you that needs to work, what it is for you that needs to be cleared, and what it is for your soul's journey that needs to be taken care of. Because every experience is different, every single one. Your soul is unique to yourself. Your journey is unique to yourself. Your life is unique to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You planned it divinely.
Yeah.
But sometimes you have a little snag in the road.
Yep.
Or a little bump, you may say. Sometimes all you need to do is face that bump, face that snag. Don't drive around it and avoid it. Because guess what happens? You got to turn around and go back. Right, Deborah? That's Venus retrograde.
Yes.
So if you do not want to do this again in 18 months.
No, I don't.
Step inside yourself and find the deep root cause.
Yeah.
And get rid of it. Many times it is past life situations that are brought forth and connected to this life.
Yeah, I think that was the case with the past issue, too.
Yes, I believe it was. Keleena, was it? I have to view. I think it was a few of them, Elizabeth.
Okay.
But it comes to the same thing. It comes back to... Yeah. The fears that you're carrying inside. Yeah.
Okay.
But it's not this, it's not just this twin, it's other men.
Yeah.
Other relationships. So that's what I'm saying.
From past lives or this life?
Past lives.
Okay.
Past lives, definitely. Because they're showing medieval times, so that's not
this. Not now.
All right. So it is very simple. When you step into your heart, you live in simplicity. You just live in love and joy.
Okay.
Now, just because I'm saying you were stepping into your heart doesn't mean you're living in the fifth dimensional state of being.
Mm-hmm.
Stepping into your heart and living from your sacred heart is how we're supposed to live.
Yeah.
The fifth dimensional state is a whole different thing. It's a whole different space.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? It is a whole different concept.
Okay.
And everybody will get there in their own divine time.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure.
Yeah, the pleasure was all mine.
Well, no, it was mine. We will not argue this.
I won't argue with the high bean.
Oh,
I am not. No. I am just as equal to you are to me.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right, yeah. Elizabeth.
Thanks, Elizabeth, right. for Thank calling
so
in.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right.
Okay, bye.
So it looks like we have a clear line. We probably have time for
Yeah, we probably have. Oh, yeah, it is, isn't it? We probably have time for one more caller if anyone would like to get in the queue. It's star six. I'm sure we
could. Have
someone,
but they fell off.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, we did. Someone actually texted me and basically said, I've been on hold for an hour, and I'm like, I'm sorry. But we did take calls. I know, but we took calls in order that they came in, and,
right.
You know, it just is the way it is. We only, you know, we really just go with what comes to us, and so sometimes calls take a little bit longer, and I think that, you know I've gotten a lot out of just listening to what everyone else is talking about, so... would anyone else like to get in the queue is my question.
I will get in the queue.
Okay.
I will be the caller.
Will you be the caller?
Yes, I would like to talk about...
Can I give you some advice?
No.
No.
Yes, you can. All right. Okay. Here's my question.
Okay.
Because I see this often in relationships, so I would like to bring it forward so that everyone out there that is listening now and everyone that will listen to this eventually.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Women seem to have an issue when men do not put toilet paper back on the wall.
Oh, my
and
God.
And then comes
to
the...
What the fuck? Where does this come from? Okay. Yes. It's gotten late on a Friday night. Now we've got Kane laughing so hard. So, oh my gosh, we're never gonna come down from this one.
Arguing of the ladies holding the cardboard thing.
Oh,
God, I'm sorry, okay? Oh, don't do that to me. All right, here's where I'm going with it, though. Please, there's a purpose.
Is there really?
Goodness.
Okay, please,
yes.
Get to it quickly.
It is the same as the man drinking out of the milk carton. Okay? So... The woman is upset because the man does not replace the toilet paper. And then she's upset because she catches him drinking out of the milk carton. Tell me something.
Yes.
In your expertise. When the twins get together and they're in a sacred union and their holy matrimony or whatever you wish to call it and your earth in your earth terms.
Yeah.
Is it a harmonic relationship when those things happen? And what if they do happen in these relationships? How are you going to handle those little things? Is it a past life situation? Is it a past life situation when the man does not replace the toilet paper? Did he do
probably
that in another
not.
Life?
No,
all right.
Probably not. No.
Oh,
right. I get your point, though. I get your point. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes, I get it.
Okay.
All right. So now what you're doing is you're asking like if we step into a time when we're actually, say, living with someone like we are in our karmic relationships, what is the nature of that connection going to be and how are things going to be? And you want to know what I can honestly say? My heart tells me, if I go into my heart tells me that there will be a lot of laughing and humor about it, you know, instead of, Because unconditional love means you don't need someone to show up in a particular way in order for them to be acceptable to you. If there's something that, you know, is a pet peeve of yours, then you would learn to laugh about it and laugh it off and say, oh, here's a friendly reminder to put this toilet paper thing on there. But, you know, and then it would kind of become a joke. It would kind of become a laughing circumstance. In other words, a light-hearted, not the end of the world, kind of let's fight about every little thing that we can. It would probably be much more an acceptance of, you know, just differences.
Yes,
exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So let me ask Keleena a question, and then I will ask you a question. And I'm going to see what your answers will be. So, Keleena, let's say you find a man eventually. Thank you! slammed me again.
Well, get in line. He slams me every darn show.
Jeez.
Master Kuthumi.
I'm just kidding. I like to. I know she's been speaking to her twin for 35 years. I know. I just like to tease her because, good God, maybe they'll never be together. Oh, my God.
Stop it.
All right. So let's say, Keleena, you get up in the middle of the night and you walk because you're a little hungry and you're going to go get yourself a raw vegetable or one of your fruits from your refrigerator. And you're walking through the room, and you step through the hallway, and boom, ow, ow. You step on something, and it hurts, and it pinches, and you step again, ow, and another, and you look down. And there's crystals all over the floor. And you say, what the? What are you going to do?
Okay.
You know there's crystals all over the floor. Why is there crystals on the floor? In sacred geometry positions. Oh, my God. What are you going to do?
I know.
What are you going to do when you step on them and you hurt yourself? You have human pain.
Keleena, do you know what he's talking about?
I'll walk around them.
But do you know what he's talking about?
What? Tell me.
Do you not know what he's talking about?
I don't want to say.
Okay, but do you know that there's a particular person that does a lot with
Yes, I know.
Okay, all right. So now you know what he's talking about.
Yeah.
Okay. I just want to make sure, because sometimes it's really strange, guys. We'll be having these conversations, and sometimes it's like, I know exactly what Kuthumi means, but Keleena's like going right over her head. And I'm like, hello? Do you get it? No, I didn't know if you saw what he's talking about.
Yeah. So are you going to be in joy? Are you going to be in anger because you are having human pain? For me, living from open heart, I would probably giggle about it because I feel it's kind of childish to leave it along the hallway.
I can't imagine.
Diagrams on the floor.
I know.
It's kind of childlike. So I'd probably giggle and just... the way I am, I'd laugh about it and just move on. Go find myself a pear or an apple. All right, then. I love that answer. Keleena, all right. Don't run into the big crystal that's in the living room because you'll probably smash your face into it and break your nose. You know which one I'm talking about. All right. Okay, thank you. All right, Deborah, your turn. Let me see. So you're sleeping in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden you hear tick, 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 tick.
Oh my gosh.
And then it's tick, 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 and it's and it's the middle of the night. And you're so very tired.
Oh no.
What are you going to do?
I'm probably going to get up and sleep on the couch. I've gotten so used to sleeping by myself that literally if I'm not going to be able to sleep because there's all kinds of noises going on, I'm not going to be in a bad mood about it at all. I'm going to go, I'm just going to go find some place I can sleep that's quiet.
All right. You're going to excuse yourself from the situation you're saying.
Yes. I wouldn't be like, wake up, wake up. Stop making that noise. Stop making that noise. Stop doing this. Stop doing that. I wouldn't do that. I would just say, you know what? It's important for both people to get a good night's sleep. I'm just going to go sleep someplace else.
Okay, so
and
let me take this a little further.
Uh-oh.
What if the only other place to go is on the floor? Will you move to the floor?
Yeah, I probably would. Well, I don't know. That's pretty uncomfortable. Oh, come on. Did you have to make this so difficult?
Yes, no, because you always give me a challenge.
I know. I love it, too.
All right.
No, I probably, you know what?
there would not, I just really think there would be a circumstance where I'd have to have a separate sleeping place to go. I'd have to. If it's on the floor, I'd have to just have to be prepared that I would have something comfortable laid out. But I don't think, now that I've been through the experiences that I have, I don't think that I would hold on to all that old way, the old behaviors of, you know, kicking the person out of the room and all that kind of stuff. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, it would be more like, if I want a good night's sleep, I'm just going to have to go find it someplace else because it's not going to be right here, right now. And not be angry.
All right, and since you don't have a pet and there is a doghouse about, you can go over there and find yourself a comfy pillow and crawl right in. Correct?
I don't know. I don't think I would go sleep in a doghouse,
Kuthumi. It's a Snoopy on the top.
No, I did not show you that. Can I tell you why? I used to draw Snoopy on Snoopy houses as a kid over and over and over again.
Oh, my God.
Isn't that weird? Kuthumi, you never cease to amaze me. That
he
always
does that all the time.
Up.
There was something There was something else he did this week where you did something the day before and he got through me and he talked right about it and you were like, what the? Did I tell you?
I know.
That
I wish I could remember what it was. He does this to me all the time.
Because he's always watching. They are always watching us. They're always watching.
I know. Especially when, you know,
it's 11:30.
I know. Just before
just
we hang up
with.
And get. I know. But I do want to say that when you make a connection with the other side and you know who your guides are, right now I'm very blessed to have Kuthumi as one of my guides. And through Keleena Malnar, I actually get to hear a physical being speaking to me. The blessings that you have with that, you know, it's just amazing. And those things are really available to us. Anyone that wants to have that experience. Some people don't choose to have that experience. Some people, you know, don't. I know that for a longest time, I didn't have any connections with any beings on the other side. But I just want to say, Kuthumi, that it's just been such an honor to have you be one of my guides. And I do know that you're always watching because there's certain things that he talks about. It's like, how could he possibly know that? Because Keleena doesn't know it. So,
yes, that's true.
2 years of testing, Kuthumi, over and over, questions. Well, what about this? Well, what about that? Well, what about this?
But what I must remind you is that even though you thought you were testing me, I was testing you.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
And I appreciate it.
Time to rise in your vibrations.
Yep.
Time for everyone to rise in their vibrations. Ascension is calling. It is time for you to get on with your journeys. And I will step back now in love, light, and blessings to all of you because I have another show to go do.
I have another show. Okay.
I am very booked. So
I'm very booked.
All right. Much love and blessings to all of you and deep gratitude for all of you for the service that you do. You chose to come here, and I didn't.
Smart guy. Thank you, Kuthumi. Thank you, love
Good
you.
Good night. Much love and
all
in
right.
love.
Much love. Good night. Keleena, is it going to take you just a second?
Yeah. Yeah, he's gone. Tiemme on oma että kun on ruosse pekiante, jo tiemme on jo kotiessa se triante mea. A kone anemikin tiemme tiemme. Mea kiteen.